Hello everyone, welcome to our channel. Today we are going to deal with concept of health and it is from the subject Human Health and Community Pharmacy from the course first year in Diploma of Pharmacy. Let us start. The very first it is health. The very first thing we are going to deal with today is health, and health is defined as complete physical, mental and social well-being and not merely absence of disease. Please pay attention. Most of the people think that if a person does not have any kind of disease, that person is completely healthy. But it is not like that. The thing is, one person should be physically, mentally and socially, that person should be fit. Socially fit in the sense that person should be like be in peace, with harmony with other people and other kind of communities. So that is complete, we can say that person is completely healthy. So that is health, and this definition is given by WHO, that is World Health Organization. Please pay attention to the definition and write as it is given on the slide in your exam. Let us move to the next one, the dimensions. Now dimensions of health, as you can see on the slide, dimensions of health, there are four. There are many other kinds of dimensions, but we are just going to study this very important four types, or we can say four dimensions. The number one we are going to see is physical, after that mental, then social and then spiritual. Now, why are we going to study this dimensions of health? What is the need to study the dimensions of health? So as we can see, this physical is related to the mental related to spiritual, and spiritual to social, and the social to physical. That means in short, this four dimensions are interrelated, we can say. So this importance, the interrelation, their importance, that we are going to deal within dimensions of health. So please pay your kind attention. Yes, the number one we are going to see is physical, and here after physical it is health. So it is health everywhere, here it is understood, so I have not mentioned. So it is physical health, mental health, social health and spiritual health. So let us first start with the very first, that is physical health. Now physical health, everyone knows about it. And likewise, we will be going to see mental, social, spiritual. So physical health deals with normal functioning and growth of all parts of the body and the body as a whole. That means normal functioning of body is known as physical health. And the few characteristics are being provided to you or being given to you, that is clean skin, good appetite and sound sleep. So these are characteristics. If a person possesses this, that means person is physically healthy. So that person will be called as physically healthy. So this is the first dimension of health. The second, mental. Let us move to mental health. That is, the characteristics given here are self-satisfaction, adjustment, self-control. So let us move to mental health. It has importance in order to live in harmony. So only we will be known as that we are mentally healthy. Now characteristics, as you can see, self-satisfaction. That means person should be satisfied with himself, and that person should not have any inner conflict. That means self-satisfied a person should be. So that is the self-satisfaction. After that is adjustment. So person should learn to adjust with other, we can say, caste, communities or other people who criticizes you or like that. you should be adjusting. You should not go and fight for simple reasons, simple things. So that is your mental health. That decides your mental health. Third one is self-control. That means you should have a good self-control. You should have control over your anger, fear, jealousy, worries. So that is about your mental health. The second one, mental health. Let us move to your social health now. Social, as the name, you must be knowing. Social means, we can say, living with all the communities, caste, religion, people, very friendly way. So that is social. So you should be socially healthy. That means you should accept other caste, community, race, people, and you should mingle with them. That is the characteristic. You should be a member of society, then you should possess social skills and also social functioning. Like if there is some festival, but you are not from that community, still you wish them, the other community people, you wish them and you be together with their celebration. That kind of things is social health. That means you are accepting the other people. That means you are socially healthy. After that, it is spiritual. We can say last one, spiritual. Here it is physiology and psychology. Now, what does that mean? Physiology and psychology is your body and mind should be at peace and at harmony. So that means spiritually you are healthy. You should be doing yogas and meditations to be healthy. Spiritual here does not only relate to your religion, but it is with your body and mind. Some of the people think that spiritual, that means it is related to their God, their religion, but it is not like that. Person should have a prospective towards being at peace and being in harmony. So that is all about spiritual. Now, these were the four dimensions of health. Let us move to the next one. Now, this is, as you can see, there are no headings and I have just tabulated the data. So let us now understand what it is. So here, as you can see, determinants and their functions. So I'll be explaining you about determinants. So determinants, we can say that things which determine health of the person, that is known as determinant in simple language. Now you can see here heredity, then environmental factors, then lifestyle, and then socioeconomy. The first you can see heredity, after that environment, lifestyle, then fourth is socioeconomy. After that you are going to see health services, and then at last other health related services. These are determiners. So let us now deal with this one by one. Number one is heredity. But before that, let me explain you about determinants. So yes, let us have a look what are determinants. So determinants, as I said, they are determiners of health. They are what? Determiners of health. So they have a major impact on society and they are very much of importance. The number one is heredity. Now here the function is written as health depends on genetic constitution. The very good example we can say about heredity is genes determine the health of an individual from the moment of conception. That means the genetic makeup. We cannot alter our genetic makeup. Some of the diseases are genetically inherited. So that disorders or that health issues cannot be, we can say, altered. So that is heredity. Health depends on genetic constitution. The number two is environment. Now, as you know, environment is surrounding. So here environment can be internal. This is internal or external. Internal relates to your own body. examples tissues, organs, and external relates to physical, biological, psychological components. Now, biological, that means various animals, plants, we can say microorganisms. So they are external factors which are having an impact on our health. Then physiological, we can say, as we saw in social health. So physiological or physical, we can say, physical we can say about land, air, water. If the land or air is polluted, water is polluted, we will be having effect on our health. So that is physical. And psychological. Psychological is if you are having a fight with your, we can say, neighbors, relatives all the time. That time also you are not mentally healthy. You are mentally disturbed. So therefore, here it has come psychological components. Psychological components includes fights, then jealousy, all that things. So it is about environment. Then the lifestyle. Lifestyle determines whether the person is healthy or not. Lifestyle, that means the way people live. Some of the people are very much dependent on alcohol. They are alcoholic, they are smokers. So that kind of people will never be healthy. So that is about your lifestyle, the way you live. That's it, the way you live. In exam, you can expand it on, like you can write about alcohol, then smokers. That all you can write. And in lifestyle, you can mention that if the person is regularly on a walk or doing exercise, meditating, doing yoga, so that person will never have risk of like cancer, diabetes or heart diseases. So in lifestyle, you can mention that. After that, there is socioeconomic. That means number one is income. Then education, nutrition, and then occupation. So let us move one by one. Income. Rich people have capacity to seek for better medical, we can say, treatment, medical care. So in a country like India, only the rich people have facilities of good medical, we can say, healthcare systems and all. So therefore income has come. After that, it is education. Education is of very importance for the females over here. That means if a female is educated, that female can take good care of her, physical fitness and other social well-being, mental well-being, all that things. And also the female is like, she can teach, she has to raise a family, so she can teach her children to how to behave, how to be in healthy condition, all that things. So therefore education is not only important for females, also equally important for males, but on a large scale in our country, education should be provided, like it should be, it is a very much the need for the time is to educate females. So that is about education. And after that, it is nutrition. Now nutrition over here is, if the person is on starving condition, so that person will not have a good health. And nutrition, again, it has like it is proportional to your money. Like if you have good amount of money, so your nutrition value in the food will be high. So this is the thing that one should see in a country like India, that nutrition should be provided to each and every individual. And that could be done by providing occupation. So that is the fourth one. Occupation, that means the people should have, job in order to seek a good life, in order to have a good life. And if they have a good life, so they will be having a good healthy life. Only not the good life, it will be a healthy life. So it is about occupation. Let us move to the fifth point. It is health services. Health services. Now, health services, in this I have mentioned about water supply as well as immunization. Water supply, why? If a citizen of the country is supplied with very good and we can say pollution-free water, that individual will not have any infection, any disorder, and that person will be healthy. Or the whole citizen or the different communities, the different religions, if everyone get the water supply of, we can say, pollution-free water, so that might be a good indicator for health. Now, immunization. Each and every person should be immunized. That means vaccinated. Immunization is process of giving vaccine. So this is also the health services should be provided. And the sixth one is other health related services. Again, the same thing, agriculture, education, industry and rural development. That means agricultural facility should be improvised so that farmers can earn and then they could lead a better life, healthy life. Education, as we have discussed, industry. If there will be rise in industry, at the same time, government should see to it that the industries are following the rules the rules which are given to them in order to reduce the pollution, or they should treat the effluents before releasing them into the water bodies and in the atmosphere. So all that things. And rural development, yes, the government should see to it that the rural development has been taking place, and all these things are related to the health. One or the other way, these all the things are related to health. That is why it is other health related services. This should be provided to each and every individual. So this was all about the determiners of health. Hey guys, if you liked our video, please do like, share and subscribe. And please press the notification bell icon so that you can get the latest updates.